entering.
I was giving Dan the business last night when we were doing a little testing.
A little testing?
So, we'll see. But my list, I think, was a little stronger. I think the Four Lilies was much, very, very important.
Oh, absolutely.
The Seal of Fire is okay. Not a huge fan of it.
And Dan is going to be on the play, so that'll be you know, very important for a matchup like this.
He's going to be able to get his Serum Visions online, sculpt his draws a little bit to anti the Thought Seizes. It looks like we had a mulligan on the side of Keenan.
Mm-hmm.
Or maybe he's still shuffling. Dan probably maybe presented already.
I didn't quite see.
Yeah, it looks simply presented right now where Keenan's still shuffling.
Yep, looks like they're just going to shuffle up each other's decks and then go for their opening sevens.
Yeah, I think Dan being on the play is really important in this. In the matches that we played last night, play draw was fairly important, I think. Dan has really explosive draws, and if John doesn't have the discard spell on one,
mm-hmm.
I mean, you've got eight cards to get there.
Yep.
You know what I mean? And if you don't hit it within those eight cards and are able to cast it reasonably on turn one, you know, say, sub any Raging Ravines you have to draw, you need to be able to interact with Dan quick, because he can turn to you very easily. There's a guide in his hand.
I see a spirit guide, yeah. So, can't really catch a glimpse of the rest of the cards, but
I see
it looks like
lands,
he's keeping it.
Like,
yeah, looks like he's keeping it.
I see a couple lands, Through the Breach, Simian Spirit Guide, maybe Emrakul Grizzlebrand.
I thought I saw one of the fatties in there too.
Yeah, there's a Gorios right on the edge there.
Yeah, so this looks like about as good as Dan could ask for, as long as there's a discard outlet, so.
Yeah.
Yeah, there's a Serum Vision too. Looks like a great hand from Dan, so. Looks like they're both going to go ahead and keep here.
Yeah, we're probably short maybe one piece. Maybe we just need the payoff creature.
Sure. Not quite sure what the communication.
Yeah.
Communication is here. I thought it looked like Dan wanted to keep his hand. Maybe Keenan has a tough decision. Maybe that's what it is. Nope, just getting the go-ahead to go. So here goes Dan with the crack fetch and I believe Serum Visions.
We have Serum Visions more than likely. I think if I'm noticing anything about Dan's hand, like I said, I think we're just missing the fatty to pay off everything.
Yep.
Which hopefully the Serum Visions can find us in the next three cards. If not, we'll probably see Dan just draw his card, bottom both cards.
Yeah, definitely just digging for that. Maybe would consider keeping something like a Faithless Looting. So.
Yeah. Probably any draw spells off the top were reasonable. It looked like a Through the Breach, something
He picked up a Breaking and Entering
for
the draw step, so. Maybe we'll live to see the dream here. And just passes back after bottoming both of those.
Okay.
Keenan does have the Thought Seize to go ahead and lava axe himself, as we like to say.
Yeah, very, very necessary in this situation, because if he doesn't have it, Dan's likely to be able to kill him next turn.
Yep, and, you know, in this matchup, life total is almost irrelevant. The Emrakul obviously won't always kill you on the first hit,
mm-hmm.
but it kills you, essentially. So,
yeah.
The life total, you know, it shouldn't matter too much here that he's taking a pretty big hit of 5.
15, actually, the sweet spot for Dan Ward, because that's lethal for Emrakul.
It is, yeah. So, yeah. Like you had mentioned, missing just basically... Now he needs a discard, too, but he's got enough mana that he could work his way up to the Through the Breach, should he just draw one of the big fatties.
Yeah, honestly, you can just cast Breaking, targeting yourself.
Try to get some stuff in the yard.
Mill 8 cards, and then you'd probably be able to cast the Gorios next turn.
Yeah, the one worry about that is if you hit the Emrakul, you're going to lose everything, but at the same time...
Yeah, but we could just wait till we hit the third land drop, and
sure,
then be able
and have
to exile
the
guide and just go both.
And Keenan smartly gets rid of the Gorios, because that's going to be the most explosive one.
We
and there was
a Grizzlebrand.
Grizzlebrand off the top, but, you know, Dan's working his way with that Spirit Guide. In just two turns, he'll be able to Through the Breach it, so.
Yeah, we need to hit one more land off of our draw steps, and then we can cast the Through the Breach.
Yeah, let's see what Keenan has on the follow-up. Looks
probably
like
another
discard
spell.
Yeah,
that's another Thoughtseize.
Very, very strong here.
Yeah.
This is kind of the start that
Keenan
is going to be the...
this one. Yeah.
No, you don't get the Grizzlebrand, I don't think. I don't think you want to put it in the yard. I think that he probably just takes the Through the Breach.
Yeah, I can see that being reasonable.
Because then a top deck Gorios would just be a disaster for Keenan. Yep, through the breach gone, and basically telling Dan, all right, you're gonna have to top deck here.
I'm gonna go fetch. And what if we have another discard spell?
That would be pretty backbreaking, I think.
What do we take, though? Both of the cards in hand don't do all that.
Probably breaking and entering. Yeah. Once you see that card, you know something's up with it.
Yeah.
I would imagine that the word of mouth has gone around about the cascade effect.
Interesting. We're just going to go for Bolt?
Possibly. Oh, yeah, he has the one on Lava Mancer. Sure.
Not quite threatening, but a threat nonetheless.
Yeah, it's not nothing. Keenan is down to 10, but again, life total should be very irrelevant here, but yeah, he does have to watch it a little bit.
I think the only thing Dan really needs to focus on is getting his opponent to 15, and once his opponent's at 15,
yeah, now it's one just hit, lethal. One hit from a Gristlebrand, though.
There's Goryeo's off the top. Max yep. Mitchell calling it out.
Yeah, I mean, I think it would be crazy to take the... All right, yeah, I think Dan's thinking about the breaking and entering here. And to just try to, yep, going to try to, in top eight, hit, you know, one of his threats, and then he can Goryeo's it out while his opponent is tapped out. So go ahead, top eight cards here, and there it is. Let's see, if he just hits Emrakul, that's just game, but Gristlebrand is probably going to be good enough. He'll be able to draw probably 14 cards here. He might just draw the 7, we'll see. So, that in the art. He doesn't even need to respond to the trigger here, actually. That's only with the Emrakul.
Yeah. Sounds like he's passing. Or no, card in hand request.
Yeah, the one thing Dan's maybe a little worried about, he would have to give Keenan a
1-1 spear, which can block the Gristlebrand.
Yeah, exactly. So, he's just going to wait till the next turn, unless he's prompted by something like Scavenging Ooze plus the land.
Yeah.
We got the Seal of Fire. These are the all-stars in this matchup, right?
Absolutely. Probably the best card in the matchup.
All right, so this is on Keenan's end step. Going to bring back the Gristlebrand, so now he can untap. Dan just wants his 3 mana the next turn, so now he can try to go for the win. He's going to draw up to probably... I guess right now he can actually only draw 7 cards.
Yeah,
but if he hits the right combination of 7 here, he'll just be able to win.
Yeah, we should be able to untap... and attack, though. Once we can attack, then we can draw 7 more cards.
Yeah, exactly. He's seeing if he can just win on this main phase if he found the right combination of Emrakuls and...
Yeah.
And discard. But either way, he's in a great spot here. Not going to actually end up doing any damage to Keenan. The token has flying or no?
It should, yeah.
I think it's a 1-1 flyer.
Yeah, it's a 1-1 spirit.
Haven't played with that card too much. So here comes a Faithless Looting. Maybe Dan's going to find the perfect... See... He really likes to hide those cards from us, but it didn't look... I think it's another Gristlebrand, which isn't going to help here, as it's legendary.
It's going to be able to allow us to do some combo shenanigans.
It'll allow us
after this Gristlebrand goes away.
Yep. And there's a Collective Brutality. I wonder how many modes he's going to... Oh, he has the Emrakul in his hand. I'm curious to see if he has another...
Goryeo's.
Yeah, because he has the Spirit Guide. Okay, nope. Just going to go ahead and get a bunch of Gristlebrands in the yard.
Okay.
Response is to go ahead and nick Dan for 2. Turn down to 7.
I wonder if the two modes Dan chose were... Oh, no, he chose...
I think
Duress.
He's gonna kill. He's choosing all 3 because he's discarding 2.
Okay. So Duress. Kill
he sees
thing.
A couple of bolts. So that would be interesting if Dan hadn't had this Duress effect. How much life he would have paid. Though again, I don't think it's gonna be enough for Keenan here, seeing as he's missing the land drops too.
Yeah. All right. So we got rid of the Grim Lava. Got rid of a bolt. Double bolt. Seal of Fire is a lot of damage.
It is, but Dan's about to go back up to 14, and I think he's going to have all he needs. We'll see how much he wants to draw after the attack here.
We're going to be a little higher than 14 because of the drain gain off of the Collective Brutality, which is nice.
Correct.
Like, after having seen Keenan's hand, I'm pretty excited about the 2 life.
Yeah, Dan's actual holding is not great. Looks like Keenan maybe forgot that he has the blocker here.
He might just be choosing not to cast it, because if he draws another bolt, we're in decent territory if Dan tries to
Oh, actually, interesting line would have been for Keenan to block with the spirit and then seal a fire his own thing. And then maybe he would just sack out. I think he was one short because he had two bolts in his hand, not three.
Yeah, and we got rid of one. And he got rid of one.
Okay, so never mind. Dan would not have been low enough for that to work.
Spirit doesn't fly?
The token may very well not fly. I thought it did. No, okay, just the spirit. Yeah, so I just always kind of associate spirits with flyers.
Yeah, absolutely.
Okay, so the spirit does not actually have flying, so forgive me saying he could have blocked.
It looks like we have Akari Zevs in hand. Got an Emrakul. Looks like we're going to clean up.
Yep, so Dan should be able to...
We got the break and entering in hand as well.
Dan should be able to take this one down.
Plenty of threats in the graveyard.
Especially because Keenan's light on lands here and won't be able to even fetch at this point.
Yeah.
Yep, so Dan's just going to manicure a perfect 7 here before discarding, and I would assume he's going to win the following turn.
Yeah. Keenan's really, really in a tough spot. Most of his lands aren't even going to be active at this point.
Yeah, and just with no board presence. Like, he had the good start at the beginning with a bunch of the Thought Seizes, but didn't have the goy for the pressure to really back it up, and
yeah.
I think that's the recipe to winning. It's also really nice for Dan to take down game one. I think that these kind of matchups, you really do expect to win your game ones,
yeah.
And it gets a little bit harder post-board.
You have three Emrakuls in the hand?
He has a lot of Emrakuls. He does have to consider, you know, he doesn't want to discard those and shuffle away.
Yeah, he's got three in hand.
Yeah, so he just pitches four lands and passes with a full house of Emrakuls.
Position off the top.
Yeah, go out with some info, why not? Yeah, there's the Kari Zev, so that's got to be the take here. Yeah, otherwise, absolutely that's just game. The take.
I mean, I guess he can take the breaking and entering because breaking has the two converted.
Okay, sure,
mana
you
cost.
Can take that. Yeah, I forgot about that. Well, no, because then he would just be able to take the.
Yeah, he can actually threaten kill with the spirit.
Yeah, then the seal of fire.
But you get the seal of fire. But, yeah, we took the right card. We have a spirit guide and a land in hand, right?
Yep.
We just hard cast entering, can't we?
Is that six? He might just be able to hard cast entering. Yeah, I think he's reading it himself, and that's what's about to happen.
Yeah, Exile spirit guide, just hard cast entering.
Yep, and he'll get that Gristlebrand back. Yeah. It doesn't have haste, though, does it?
It does.
Okay. Yeah, I don't know what any of these cards do.
So the busted part about breaking and entering...
But the card sticks around. That's maybe
is the worst part about breaking and entering for your opponent is, like, even though it does cost 6 mana, it's a legitimate
gains haste,
get a creature
and it sticks
back.
Around. Okay.
Gains haste doesn't go away. And that's why the Kari Zevs, I think, is extremely powerful in this deck. I think it's going to breathe some just awesome life into a deck like this.
Definitely. So, you being the Jund Master, take a look at this sideboard, see what maybe we're... Definitely some inclusions that are going to be awesome.
Surgical Extraction, of course. Mm-hmm. Dan has, what, 8 payoff threats, and you can hit one of them, then Dan's percentages of being able to hit something goes way down.
He can also get the 2-for-1 if, you know, with the trigger on the stack.
Yeah. Grafdigger's Cage, just another Graveyard Hate spell. And I think we probably want, like, the Kitchen Finks. And the reason I say that is everyone's going to be like, why would we want Kitchen Finks in a matchup like this? We have a lot of dead cards, main board.
It's probably better than Grim Lavamancer.
So I'd keep even Grim Lavamancer, but like our Abrupt Decays do literally nothing.
Okay, sure, right? Literal nothing.
So those two cards. Lilliana Lasso, literal nothing.
Fatal Push,
nothing. Literal nothing. So okay, that's 5 like cards that do nothing. So we need 5 cards from the board
at least attacks
that
for
do
3.
Something,
okay,
right?
I like it.
Kitchen Finks, and it survives the Emrakul attack, right? Yep. So if we get to a point where Dan's at a semi-low life total,
might
then we
relevant,
go
yeah.
attack for 2, play a land, bolt you, we can kill Dan, right?
Yep.
Niche corner cases, but... Always better than Fatal Push. Always better than Abrupt Decay.
Definitely.
So, I that's what I was doing playing the sideboarded games last night. I was like, wow. I was going through my deck, and I was like, all right, these are fine. You know, I don't really need anything else for my sideboard. Then I was like, I found an Abrupt Decay. I was like, wow, this card's really bad. I need to get rid of this, too. So, I was like, I boarded in, like, a Painful Truce and a Kitchen Fink. So
yeah,
like,
just for something.
Need not horribly dead cards in my deck. So.
Yeah, Dan, I don't think it's going to change too much. He might bring in the Fatal Push or the Murderous Cut as an out to Scavenging Ooze.
Mm-hmm.
But other than that, I mean, I don't really see anything that...
Painful Truths.
Okay, you think he'll bring that to go long?
So, it's not as much going long, it's to refuel.
Recoup the
right? Because Jun's going to be on the play this time, so they're going to be like, turn one Thoughtseize, turn two Thoughtseize, turn three to rest Thoughtseize, just try to tear apart Dan's hand.
Sure.
Dan's going to be able to cast a Painful Truce, refuel, keep going. You know what I mean?
Makes sense.
The Collective Brutalities, another card that's semi-decent in this matchup.
Yep.
We kill Confidants, we kill Oozes, we kill Grim Lavamancers.
Ooze is kind of
important.
Can be good
too, yeah, yeah, Ooze is kind of important because it can stop us from Goryeos. It can stop us from doing other stuff.
Yeah, I like it, but I think Dan, he keeps almost the same shell. Like,
yeah.
He's just trying to go fast, and yep. That's his Dan, go-to.
Dan wants to move away from just relying completely on the combo and have some more draw spells, have some more interactive spells. So, I think it's going to be a little bit closer. I think this particular sideboard in Jund is a little weaker. Like, there's no other discard spells. You know, mm-hmm. It's just the Surgical and the Grafdigger's Cage. We can get one of those two cards.
A couple of bullets.
I think, you know, we're going to do really, really well in this game. The Grafdigger's Cage stops the Breaking and Entering, stops the Faithless Looting to pass from the sideboard or the graveyard. So, I think if we can get the Grafdigger's Cage, Dan's in a little bit of a rough spot. And I think Dan knows this, and he might hedge and bring in the Vandal Blast from the sideboard.
Yeah, he might. So, looks like Dan kept his 7, and I believe Keenan is going ahead and
mulling
it down to 6. He does have some of these very painful, or rather very powerful, you know, bullet-type sideboard cards that, you know, as even if he mulligans down to 5, say, and finds them, can really slow Dan down. And, you know, simple Tarmogoyf could just go the distance if we have it early.
Yeah, if we can go, like, Grafdigger's Cage into Goyf, and Dan doesn't have a removal spell, then the Goyf can definitely start pulling its weight.
Yeah, I think that that's the recipe for Keenan. He's got to have some disruption. I think we got a broken sleeve, maybe.
Yeah, I think the other thing about this is the Grafdigger's Cage shutting off one portion of it is another reason why we like the Painful Truths, because the Painful Truths is going to get us the lands, get us the Through the Breaches, and get us the big spells to be able to cast them through the Grafdigger's Cage and Surgicals.
Yeah, for sure. You got to be a little worried from Keenan's side when Dan snaps off a 7, though.
Yeah.
And then rips your sleeve while he's shuffling. That's the intimidation factor. He's like, yeah, you replace that sleeve. So when you're in this spot as a Jund player, are you still feeling confident with your deck? Or are you getting a little nervous on your mulligan here?
I'm a little nervous. Mm-hmm. It depends on what the mulligan looked like. If the mulligan was like a snap mull, there's not much I can do. You gotta
exactly,
ship it
you
back.
Gotta do it. Sure.
But if we're looking, there's so many hands with this deck that are just like no discard interaction where you're looking at like bolts, terminates, goyfs, and you're like, this is such a good Jund hand.
It's a Jund hand,
but it does
not in this
nothing
deck.
Against this deck, right? So like, I'm very willing to go to 5 against this matchup if I can find a Grafdigger's Cage or a Surgical against Dan.
Mm-hmm.
Those are two very important things, and I like the ability to interact with Dan more than I like a lot of cards in my hand.
Definitely. Well, King kept a 6 and bottomed the Scry, so
this looks like a really slow hand. I see 3 red-green lands in his hand.
Yeah, and Raging Ravine on 1, like Dan, you know, he's got to be licking his chops here that he didn't get a Thoughtseize or
yeah, I think we drew a Colgan's Command, which is okay.
It's pretty bad here. Let's not sugarcoat it. The discard's going to be bad. And yeah, as you mentioned, another Raging Ravine.
I would have probably shipped this hand back.
You think just go for the hopeful 5 of hitting one of your bullets and maybe
we're just, I mean, like, even without the bullets, we're just not casting discard spells. Yeah. And, like, we really need to interact with Dan, otherwise he's just going to kill us.
Yeah, and even the first threat, even if it's Tarmogoyf, it's going to be a small Tarmogoyf.
Yeah.
So, see what Dan can put together on turn 2, just a land pass. He's got all the time in the world here facing no pressure. And there's an uncastable Liliana unless a Twilight Mire comes down.
All right,
basic swamp into Thoughtseize, but
Dan's hand's probably phenomenal against this.
Yeah, it's okay. I mean, you take the Through the Breach here. Dan was actually about
one
to cast the
turn
3. Yeah. So, Dan could either... So, the Through the Breach is definitely going to be the card that gets taken here.
Yeah.
I guess Keenan could go for the next level line, take the Emrakul, shuffle it away, but that seems too risky to me. So, Through the Breach going to be gone, but again, Dan, you know, he can just draw another one of those, draw Seam Visions, draw Faithless Looting. Anything like that's going to be
a lot of draw spells that get us out of this.
Exactly. Any kind of a filtering or
and
draw.
The Painful Truce would be phenomenal off the top.
That would be a good one. I think Faithless Looting would be his best draw right now, since he has a couple extra lands, and now at this point can try to find exactly what he needs.
Yeah.
But yeah, under still no pressure from Keenan, which is definitely favoring Dan.
Hey, even if Keenan draws another black source to be able to play the Liliana. Dan's just got a lot of chaff of extra lands and Simeon's.
Yeah, he's got stuff to discard.
These just get rid of.
Yeah, Black Cleave, pass. Oh, we're casting a Spirit Guide. This is next level.
Well, we're at the point where we have a lot of lands in our hand. We can hard cast the Through the Breaches whenever we want to. And if Keenan doesn't do anything, then like...
Yeah, getting him down to 15. A lot of times you end up doing this after an Emrakul, but if he just gets down to 15...
And if Keenan tries to resolve a Liliana here, and he goes, Liliana, make you sacrifice Simeon Spirit Guide, we're like, sure.
Exactly.
You know, you just wasted a turn on a Simeon Spirit Guide.
Yeah. That's definitely a win for Dan if that happens. All right, there's another basic. Basic swamps. So, see if it's a Kalidus or just that Liliana that we saw floating around in his hand.
Kalidus would be okay now that Dan's played a spell.
Yeah, it would be okay.
But it looks like it's going to be the Liliana.
Yep, Liliana. I'm curious if he's going to make him sack it.
It's hard, right?
Yeah, because at the same time, you almost sometimes don't want to let Dan discard.
Yeah.
But he's going to opt to go for the plus here. Just the land. You know, if you're in Keenan's spot, the last thing you want to see is a Gristlebrand. But
yeah. I think he devalued Colgan's Command a lot more than he should have. I think the random discard is rough, but like if you keep ticking Liliana up, you can go Shock Spirit Guide, make you discard another card.
Sure, yeah, that could.
I think just starting hitting Dan for more cards than he can draw is kind of important.
Yeah, because once Dan, as you mentioned, gets up to this, you know, this amount, all right, this is some funny modern action. I don't know the last time I remember seeing two Spirit Guides on the battlefield at once against a Liliana, but
never, probably.
Probably never. And the thing is, if Keenan just has no resistance, though, these are actually going to put some pressure.
Keenan should have a land in his hand, and he can play his fifth land, so he can start activating Raging Ravines.
He looks like he's opting to discard it. I guess he has one more holding.
He's got a Stomping Ground in hand.
Okay, and the K Command.
Well, he discarded a K Command. I don't know what else is in his hand.
Okay, the Shock. So maybe the race is on with the...
Well, we can protect the Liliana.
Nope, we're going to aggro.
All right, so we don't care about the Liliana is what we're saying.
Yep.
I think I would value the Liliana a little higher, but that's probably just me.
Yeah, we'll see. Card in his hand is still a mystery to me. You're correct about him discarding the K-Command. I had missed that that was the card he discarded.
Yeah, again, I value it a little bit higher than a normal person would in this matchup, because if we're going on the Liliana random discard, more random discards better than just a single.
Sure.
So I like going with a little
bit more.
So
there's the Gristlebrand. Now Dan's basically just going to need to go ahead and draw Through the Breach or, you know, way to discard it.
Yeah.
And, you know, as crazy as it sounds, he's, what, 3 mana away from hardcasting it? Guess he needs... 2 black sources, though.
No, we need 1, right?
Is it triple or quadruple?
I think it's 4. We have 3.
Oh, he has 3. I missed the Blood Crypt. You're right. So, yeah. I mean, the way this game is going, that's not inconceivable to me.
Yeah, and Keenan is at 15 now, so Dan doesn't reasonably have to attack all that much more.
Yeah, he can start
like,
holding back.
One more attack would probably be fine to get him under the 14 mark for a double Grizzlebrand attack. So, like, I see sending one Spirit Guide, chomping with the other Spirit Guide at this point.
Sure, just buys himself a turn.
Is Gristlebrand 8 total mana?
Yeah, I believe Gristlebrand's 8.
Okay, so Dan opts not to attack. I guess hedging against a removal spell.
Yeah, definitely doesn't want to just take a huge chunk here from that ravine. Yeah.
Looks like he's got the Surgical in hand. I think Keenan drew a Surgical.
He might have the Surgical. Again, at this point, it might not help because of Through the Breach is going to be.
Yeah.
All right, Dan just goes for the chump here. Through the Breach at this point is definitely... what Dan's looking for.
A Painful Truce would be nice.
That would be a good one too, for sure. Yeah, he's thinking about it. Not sure what it is.
I think we got a Gorios in hand.
Okay, and he's worried about... No, it is the Painful Truce. You called it off the top. I think he was maybe considering how... If he should do 2 or 3.
Yeah.
And he goes for 3.
Right, because Raging Ravine's a 6/6 going to 7.
Yeah.
So I guess it's fine doing it for 3. Oh, no, we're at 5 now?
Yeah.
Like 2 to 3 I don't think matters if we're at 8 when we're casting it, because it's a 7/7. So any point of damage that we take here is going to kill us. So I think he's fine with just sending the life total down.
Yep, so Dan goes ahead and fetches a basic here, and let's see if there's some fireworks this turn.
I'm not sure. Having drawn three cards, we have a spirit guide in
here. Another spirit guide.
I think we have a Through the Breach, too.
There's one mana, Faithless Looting. So right. Draw two, discard two. We know he has the fatties, but as you had alluded to, Keenan may have the surgical.
Yeah, if Keenan has the surgical in hand, this is very good for him.
Oh, it'd be amazing. Because if it's the Emrakul that Dan puts in the yard, all of the rest of the graveyard gets shuffled in, and that loses the flashback on that Faithless
Looting. Yeah, I think we're hitting the Grizzlebrand, because I know we've got Grizzlebrand in hand.
Mm-hmm.
And I don't think we have an Emrakul in hand.
Okay, I thought I'd seen one. I've definitely seen the Grizzlebrand.
Yeah.
In question.
I think we have a Kari Zebs in hand, too, it looks like.
That'd be interesting. Now, no current legal target. Well, I guess you can target it on yourself, or no? Some threatened effects you can.
Yeah, you can target... I think you can target any creature.
Okay, most threatened effects you can. I'm not sure about that one.
Yeah. Target creature or vehicle until end of turn.
Okay.
So you can target your own. Give him haste.
Yep, so
I've had somebody do that to me before.
Dan goes for another looting here after discarding...
We got another Painful
Crystal Brand. Yeah, at this point, Painful Truths, though. Can't really be casting that.
Yeah, I think anything... Once we get to the three life range, we're in a little bit of trouble.
Yeah, Jun does keep the bolts in.
They're not anything if something to keep your Grizzlebrands honest.
Yep.
Discarded the Painful Truth. Assuming Spirit Guide, it looked like.
Yeah, and has to just say go, so... Didn't find a way to cheat one of those creatures back. And also...
Maybe draw a Thrun.
Alright. There's the block. This is it for Dan. This is gonna be the turn.
I can't see what's in his hand. He's keeping it very, very secretive from us. Do have a land.
Alright. Looked like a Serum Visions, I think. No, it was a Gorios.
We got a Faithless Looting.
Okay.
As well.
I thought it was the Gorios, maybe. It looked like it was. Alright, does he have the surgical? Because it's at 15. It looks like he does.
Yeah.
Yep. So Dan would need a second
Gorios
right now to at least get the creature, and I don't think that he has a second one.
Yeah, I don't think so either. It looks like we only have a couple cards in.
Alright, well, that's gonna be game. A very timely surgical.
That was tough.
There's
that
only one really, in the really deck. Tough. Only one in the deck, but
yeah.
Yeah, I mean that was a really timely draw.
Those are the bullets. Those are what we need to win matchups like this. I think if he just doesn't have the surgical there, Dan wins that game.
Oh, very easily.
Like, I think if Dan draws probably a little bit better.
He did draw kind of poorly towards the end.
We didn't see anything for payoff cards, really. We didn't see any Through the Breach. We saw one Gorios venture. If we had a second one there, we cast it.
Yep.
So that was just a tough spot.
Definitely, but you know, I think you gotta chalk that up to the variance. Not to mention that Keenan had quite a slow hand and also had a mulligan himself, so
yeah,
you know, Dan can't be that upset.
He could be. I would probably be.
All right.
To his hand as slow as that was, missing discard spells and then drawing the one of surgical or
he doesn't
like,
know
the
it's
one
a
of one-up. Cage.
He doesn't know though. They don't know their deck.
True, but like
sure.
Having the single card like that. Granted, if that's a card we had in hand the whole time,
mm-hmm.
that's a reason I could keep a hand of like double Rage Ravine, Stomping Ground, no black source.
No,
right?
That you're also.
But I don't think he had that in hand the whole time.
No, I think he drew it.
So we had no black source to play any of our discard spells. I think I throw that hand back and draw another one. But Dan's gonna be back on the play again. It's gonna be a great position for him. It's gonna be able to get out of any of the way of the Thought Seizes. Play your Serum Visions. Get through your draw spells. Set your draws up. Make so that Thought Seize isn't as impactful as it could be. So
yep.
We'll see how this goes.
Yeah, I'm going to have to lean towards Dan. I think that he's due for at least a reasonable draw. He hasn't had anything too crazy right now, but... You know, I want to see this Kari Zev. That's all I'm asking for.
Yeah, I want to see the Kari Zevs into the Breaking and Entering. That'll be phenomenal. That's why we're playing this deck right now.
All right, they're peeling their openers here. Let's see if we can get a nice game three here.
All right, I see Breaking and Entering.
I see all the good spells out of Dan's, and I see some land, so I think he's going to go ahead and keep that one.
We shall see. Dan looks like he's good. Keenan looks like he's mulling over his hand right now.
Maybe Dan's the one in the tank. It looked like a fine hand to me, but yeah, he just said keep, and Keenan as well. So here comes the fetch from Dan, and I believe he has a Serum Visions for turn one.
Yeah, I think I saw a basic mountain in his hand, so he's got the Faithless Looting. We're just basic mountain, Faithless Looting. Mm-hmm. Like I said, sculpting our draw, Serum Visions helps us against the Thoughtseizes. We get to look at the top two cards, set those up so Thoughtseize can't mess with those. You know, the motto for Jund, you can't stop the top.
Yep, can't stop the top. Dan looks like he has all the moving parts. I think he just needs to hit a couple of land drops, and I think he should be pretty good.
Yeah. Do we have a payoff spell in hand?
I thought I saw Gristlebrand, but I'm not 100%.
Okay. So we'll, hopefully, if Keenan kept a reasonable 7, we should know what Dan's playing. The cards
the turn one fetch
off of a discard spell.
Very likely getting Thoughtseizer in positioned here, so we'll get a definitive look at Dan's hand in just a moment. And Keenan does like to preserve his life total. Maybe I'm crazy here. In his matchup, I think I would just be getting the duels. His hand might be Superman heavy, but...
So I guess we got to consider keeping over the 15 for the one-shot Emrakul attack.
Sure.
It's an interesting keep from Dan.
No, I like this keep. He's got he had the Serum Visions and he kept one on top, so.
Okay.
You know, he's got the extra payoffs. He's got one way to sneak it in. He's got the fast mana. I think it's definitely a keep.
What do we take? We only have, what, two options? The Breaking Alien and the Simian Spirit Guide?
Yep. It takes a Spirit Guide.
Yeah. The Fast Mana is the only way we're going to get to the Through the Breach.
Yep.
So, I like it. It looks like Dan drew a land for turn. I think we got a fetch off
of
that.
Yeah, it looked like a Scalding turn.
Yeah. I think we're doing all right. If Keenan can go... He can't even play a Goyf. If this is a Confidant, we're... All right.
Okay, Confidant.
These are the starts I like with Jund. Mm-hmm. This is the turn two I want to have. I want to go discard into Confidant in this matchup. Because I
want to get those cards.
Hitting more discard spells, hitting the Terminate if I need it. I want just a mass of cards in a matchup like this. Because keeping discards in our hand to be able to keep attacking Dan's stuff, finding our way to the Grafdigger's Cage and the Surgical Extraction is really important. So I like the
Dan found a nice one here, though, with the Faithless Looting. Now he gets to get rid of some of those extra Gristlebrands, and I think he found the Goryeos.
Yeah, if we get a Goryeos off this, probably just dead.
Unless the Miser Surgical again.
That would be insane. I would... He'd get the Gristlebrand out of Dan's hand because he got an extra copy.
That would be like a...
All right, discard both Gristlebrands.
Okay.
Actually, that's great for us, isn't it? Because the Surgical... Does Surgical get both of those if they're both in the graveyard?
I think so. I think it's all.
I think so as well.
Search the graveyard.
Yeah, okay. Yeah. So we get all of them.
I didn't catch what he revealed off the Bob, did you?
I didn't either. The life total should reflect what happened.
It might have
he
been
looked
a land,
like he
man.
Lost one.
No, because he had fetch turn one.
Okay, turn one fetch, so it might have been a land reveal. Got the Thoughtseize. Still got the Through the Breach. So that's, what do you think we take here?
Through the Breach.
Okay.
So now Dan's really looking for that Goryeos. Goryeos going to be the best draw here.
Got the Cage. Lavamancer.
Yeah, I'd be curious to see... I mean, I guess here Kari Zebs would be great.
Yeah, Kari Zebs would be phenomenal here because we already have creatures, so we can't miss.
Yep.
Which is a legitimate thing to think about in a deck where you only have the 8 creatures.
Yeah, and with the milling of the 8, he might just hit the Emrakul.
Yeah.
With 5 permanents on the board, I've never personally seen somebody come back from it.
My buddy likes to let people get 6 permanents, so this Emrakul is exactly perfect. But, you know, he can be mean sometimes.
Alright, back to Dan. And another land for Dan.
It's alright. We need the lands to be able to cast the Through the Breaches anyway.
Yep.
So we need to get to our 5th land.
Alright, Dan goes ahead and Faithless Lootings here on the flashback. Go ahead and discard 2 cards. I still don't think he found one of the
It looks like that was just all lands.
Yeah, a lot of lands.
I see the Spire Bluff. I see another basic in his hand.
Mm-hmm.
Right, reveal. Scooze. Take two. All right. Emrakul's lethal.
Yeah, Scooze is pretty good here, but we don't another have enough green. Not enough green to hold it up.
Yeah, I look like we drew a Goyf, too. Another way this deck gets very awkward and mana intensive. We want to be able to cast
when
all
there's
our
not
spells.
Enough green.
We do have a forest in hand.
Okay.
So we are able to cast the Scooze, but we can't cast Scooze and Goyf. Looks like Dan has an Emrakul in hand, too. So if we find a Through the Breach, we can just kill our opponent.
Yep, Through the Breach is now definitely priority number one.
Actually, we're land Simeon Spirit Guide off of just casting Entering again.
Oh, sure. Yeah, and I keep forgetting
entering,
about
pulling
entering.
The weight right now.
Hard
pulling
cast Entering.
All of the weight right
not
now.
Not exactly how you draw it up, but, you know.
Is that a Through the Breach?
It looked like it. I guess we're going to see. Maybe it was Karzev's.
That would still be
I
fine.
Think it was Karzev's, but now the Scooze kind of complicates things. No?
It does not, actually.
So oh, because there's Karzev's, no response,
it
he was
resolves
saying.
All
yeah, no,
at
no,
the same time.
I asked that same thing. You're right. You can't
and Scooze
to
can't
it.
Hit both of the Grizzlebrands in the graveyard. If he could, then it's possible that the Scooze eats those and Dan misses, right? Because he's got an Emrakul in hand.
Oh,
so
wow.
So we're missing
if,
three out of our eight targets.
What if Keenan kills his own Scooze in response? Would that fizzle the spell?
I'm not sure about that. I think the spell still goes off because you had a target when you cast it.
It's very possible. That would be something I would ask a judge. I'm
it's like a
sure.
Searing Blaze thing. Or a little Searing Blaze still has a target.
Okay, well, it looks like we're going to find out. Okay, that's exactly what happened. So it looks like it does work how I thought. The spell fizzles. Surprised that he used the Bolt rather than just
the Lava Mancer.
The Lava Mancer, but...
True. Lava Mancer, the bolt represents more damage
mm-hmm.
to Dan's face. So, okay. The more you know.
I keep missing what he's revealing. He does it very quickly.
Yeah. I'm one to leave my reveal on Confidant, because that's just how I do it.
Sure.
It's way better for coverage.
Yeah, I usually
well.
Bring it over.
Okay. Thanks, chat. I appreciate the shout-outs for the legal targets on Karzev's.
Yeah, I thought that's how it would work. And
yeah,
good play by Keenan to see that.
Yeah, Yanni's expertise would be phenomenal here.
I thought he had one on the sideboard, didn't he? Yeah, he has one in the sideboard. I don't think he brought it in, though.
Probably not. It's a little niche.
For this matchup against
Yeah,
Sparks
I think
stuff.
As it is right now, it's great. 4, 5, 6, 7 damage.
Yeah, well, this is, you know, puts Dan to the test. You got to have
Dan
something this turn.
Dead next turn.
Does he draw? Well, there's a quick fetch.
Well, we get the entering.
He's entering.
Yeah,
okay.
So you just cast the entering.
For Gristle. Yeah, that's Gristle not just brand. Game, and he can't... I don't think he... Yeah, he can't draw, so... The question is, can he attack? Goes up to 11, and then he's facing 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 on the backswing. So it might even be a little risky to attack.
Yeah, but I think... It's also risky to just leave back because we've got Liliana's Terminates,
sure,
Maelstrom Pulses.
I guess it's better to get the guaranteed 7.
Yeah, and like he's only backswinging for 8, right?
Yeah, I mean, well, it represents up to...
And Grizzlebrand doesn't go away, right?
Yeah, Gristle
sticks. If Keenan is at actual 14, mm-hmm. he is dead next turn.
There's a surgical a turn late, and that's going to ping Keenan for 1.
Yeah, so Keenan's at 6 now.
So Keenan needs a Terminate or a Liliana here.
Or a Maelstrom.
Or a Maelstrom Pulse.
Just any form of removal to get the Grizzlebrand off the floor. Maybe even Double Bolt does it. I don't know if we have enough red sources to go Bolt, Lava
I think
Mancer.
He's a red short of doing that.
Probably. But maybe if we have a fetch land.
Yep, thinking through his lines here. You know, if he's not doing something quick, I feel like maybe Dan... broke his way. He broke and entered his way out of this game. I was not
he's
expecting
trying to think of a way
to maybe make Dan mess up or think of his best line here.
Yeah. Anything he can do to try to get out of this.
Looks like it's Huntmaster to gain some life.
It's enough.
That's enough for now.
Last a turn.
That puts him up to 8. Jam your hand on the table. All right. Huntmaster trigger.
I don't think that's the best line.
No, I think it's
just jam your hand on the table.
Oh, sure.
I've done it before.
Yeah, I mean, this is the... It's now okay. He has to completely fade off of
Confidant.
The Confidant. Yeah.
He's got the red open, so he can just lava mancer it.
He can kill it himself right now, sure.
Yeah, but I think the biggest issue is not as much the fact that he's almost taking lethal as much as it is
Dan's going to gain another seven life. Yeah, well, it's off the table now. He decides to just go with Hope Confidant doesn't betray me.
Aggressive. I would do it, but Confidant likes me a lot.
So you're saying you would kill the Confidant here, or you would attack for three?
No, leave the Confidant on
the
floor.
You'd attack for three.
I don't even come close to killing Confidant. Confidant's my best friend.
The other side is 2 damage.
To you and a creature.
Yep. So Dan will be facing quite a bit of pressure on the flashback, but if he can just find a collective brutality here, that would be
lethal.
We're
going to 15 on the attack for Dan.
Mm-hmm.
Like, I think...
Dan will have a spell to cast, I think, so I don't believe Hunt Master will flip.
So I think the positive to right here is the fact that we can draw 7 cards, because he can't do anything to us to mess with our life total at the moment. Mm-hmm. So we can draw the 7 cards off of Grizzlebrand.
Sure.
Find a Brutality, cheat our Emrakul in. Yeah, I mean, if that's what we're going to lead off with, I love it. You know what I mean? We get to look at the top cards.
There's find a Through the Breach.
Yeah, Through the Breach, and I think we have an Emrakul in hand. So we just
he can just
breach,
draw the 7, go to 1.
Yeah.
Gut shot in response, I don't think Dan is too worried about, so I think that's what we're
going
to
see. If that's how I'm going out of the tournament, I'm probably quitting Magic.
No, we're just going for the Handy's Expertise again here.
Karyazev's Expertise.
I don't know what I called it, yeah.
You called it the black one.
My bad. Yeah, the Expertise.
Fine. Oh, we got just hit
steal
him with the
Lava Mancer, ping him. All right. I missed that line, that's very awesome, so...
That is awesome.
You know, the cards that Dan had innovated with really won him the game there, breaking and entering, hard cast.
I think what we used to be playing is just not going to contribute to a match like this as much as the breaking and entering contributed to this match.
Yeah.